13s and 14s. Any expectations for you junior year?
You know, hopefully play better than last year. You know, a lot more yards than last year. No injuries. Definitely, that's my main goal.
How comforting is it to know that you have an offensive line that's pretty much all back from last year? And I mean, and those guys know what to do.
It's awesome. Last year, a lot of them were just starting out varsity. And this year, they're all back. So it's just a complete turnaround from last year. And so, you know, it's going to be good.
Have you see like, because of the experience factor, that practices have gone a little bit smoothly? In fact, you're up further ahead at this time of the year than, say, last year?
Yeah, definitely. All the linemen were back, so, like you were saying, it's obviously just way quicker tempo and way deeper into our playbook than we were last year at this time.
Such a great season last year to get to the semifinals in Division III. I mean, what are you looking forward to this year?
To go far into a playoffs this year again, we got a lot of returning guys. We got a lot stepped up from the younger classes in our class. So I think we'll be looking pretty good this year.
What's it like being on a team where, I mean, you've grown up with all these guys. You played football, fourth year playing football at Bishop. Just to have those guys knowing they have your back, and, you know, just that you guys are almost like a family.
Yeah, no, it's definitely a brotherhood here. And it's like, that's probably like one of my favorite parts is just knowing that, you know, like I don't have a brother, I have a sister. But like just having these brothers here is just means everything, you know. Hey, John.
Talk about the defense a little bit. I know you lost a leader and shot well, but what about this defense this year?
Yeah, our defense looks good. I mean, losing shot well is a big person to lose. But we got Ash, who's, I mean, Ash is big time too. So I think we'll be really good this year.
And how about on the offensive end? I mean, you're on the offensive line, and I think you have everybody back, right?
Yeah, you know, our offensive line, like, you know, being tight end too, knowing all the dudes on the offensive line. We got some big boys, so it'll be fun. Then we have John in the backfield, so we'll be running well this year.
This team, the experience factor on this team must be something that you really are excited about.
Yeah, you know, Barry, it's a little bit different because in the past, you know, it would seem like our experience was in our skill position players. Receivers, returning quarterback for a couple of years with Spencer and our defensive secondary. And this, with this team, our real experience and perhaps our depth is in the line. So it's a slightly different thing. We've got to replace some playmakers, as you know, in Shotwell and Sirocco and A.B. Bennett. So we've got to be able to do that. But the good news for us is that we had a solid group of guys get playoff experience that are returning, and we do return a large number of guys on offense and defense that started multiple games for us last year. So there is a sense among a lot of the guys that they know what to expect.
A lot of coaches say it starts in the line. So I don't know if you're one of those guys, but when you have an experience line like that, does it make it, I feel like you're steps ahead of the previous season, like at this stage of the game?
Yeah, I would say that, you know, we've been able to do a little bit more with the linemen because of their experience level. We're supplemented by the fact that we've got some guys up from the JVs who are very competitive and physical and good-sized guys. And so those guys are having to get up speed, but I think they're getting pushed along faster because of the experience level of our returners. And, you know, that being said, it fundamentally comes down to execution and being physical. And what I've seen so far is that we're very competitive with one another in our line segments. And I think that bodes well for us.
I know you're gonna have a new quarterback this year. Who are the guys that are contending for the job, or do you have one picked out already?
Well, you know, we've got four guys on the roster who are quarterbacks, you know, the two that will start the season getting most of the reps are David Gladish, who was our backup to Spencer last year as a sophomore. David's a junior and done very well, progressed very well over the summer. And then Jake Engel, who was our JV starting quarterback. Jake's only a sophomore, but very sharp and very poised for his age. And so those two guys will you know, start the season and probably share reps so that they're both developing and getting some experience. David is probably the lead guy at this stage, and it's simply because of his familiarity with what we do offensively.
Okay. Well, it's got to be reassuring for either one of those guys to be handing a ball off to John Harris. I mean, that's got to help.
Yeah, I mean, John has continued to get bigger and faster, and it really comes down to his work ethic. I mean, he just pushes himself, and he's just so athletic. You know, we're going to count on him a little bit more this year because he's now going into his junior year, and certainly we think that he can carry the load. And you know, we've developed a couple other guys in the backfield that we think complement him very, very well. Evan McKeegan, who's a returning running back for us. Evan's put on 15, 18 pounds from last year and can play both the tailback and the fullback position. And then Ash Borgeson, who started for us at one of the guard positions, also moves back into the backfield as a fullback. So we've made some adjustments, but the key there is generating depth and making teams pay if all they want to do is key on John. A little bit of committee for the position that AB held. We have another couple guys that are very, very quick. Isaiah Veal, who's a track star, as you know, started at corner for us last year, and he can play that position. He's also a fine receiver. And Tommy Murillo, who also returns, was essentially AB's backup there last year, so Tommy's back. Austin Bonnet will likely start in the secondary for us, but Austin's also very, very quick. So we'll probably be rotating those guys through.
I mean, you lose a huge presence in Matt Shotwell, but you have still a lot of guys back.
Yeah, Matt was, again, one in a long line of really fine linebackers that Coach Robles has developed. And, Ashton Borgeson will, who started next to Matt last year as a sophomore, Ash will move into that role that Matt played as our Mike backer. So he's had a lot of experience, and he was played for us and played a lot as a freshman. So he's more experienced than his junior class might suggest. We returned three guys on the defensive line that played a lot last year. Eddie Miranda is one of those. Mike Agnoli is another. And at the other tackle spot, Gavin Callow played a lot last year. And then linebackers, Evan McKeegan played one of the outside backers last year as a starter, and so he returns as a junior. And, the secondary is going to have some pretty experienced guys. We lost Bailey Salcedo to graduation, but several of the other guys come back, including Harris, who can play pretty much anywhere we need him to. But Street started for us at some safety, and Isaiah Ville at one corner started, and Austin Bonnet got some starts and had the big hit in the Newberry Park game. So we've got a fair number of experienced players on the defensive side.
Okay. And then the special teams, I mean, you got Luckhurst back to kick, and he was really huge for you as a freshman to come in there. Because I know kicking game is sort of kind of in the down, not say down, but it's kind of been one of the lesser areas for Bishop Diego football over the years. But yeah, this guy has definitely stepped it up.
As a sophomore, he's the real deal, Gary. I mean, he's got so much potential. I mean, like a thrower developing arm strength, Jack's developed leg strength that just comes with working out and natural maturation, we've already been on our guys a little bit about being real smart when we get inside the 30-yard line, because we should be coming away with points if we do what we need to up front, because Jack is that accurate and that consistent. So
what do you think of your position in the division, your playoff position? Were you surprised? Were you happy? Are you?
Bira, in all honesty, still struggling to figure out the formula. In some ways, I think I understand what CIF was attempting to do. It's a very, very competitive division. There's only 22 teams in it, so essentially, what they've done is front-loaded the top divisions with fewer player, fewer teams. And that's means that top to bottom within our division, there's really high quality competition. And we got to get there, you know.
Right.
But right now, that's the focus, is game by game so we can get there. But every playoff game is going to be a barn burner, I think, the way they've got the division set up.